since we have understood what is true anomaly, we'll move forward and understand the mean anomaly. So for that, we'll have to make our ellipse again. So this is our ellipse with focus at F1 and F2. Now let's say our Earth is located at this focus. So this is our Earth right here, and let's say this is our satellite. Now this satellite will be moving around this orbit, and this point will be the perigee, and this point will be the apogee. Now let's imagine a circle which passes through the apogee as well as the perigee, and whose center is located at the midpoint of the major axis of this ellipse. This is the major axis of the ellipse. Now let's make the circle which has its center at the midpoint of this major axis. That is the center of the ellipse. So this is that point, and this is our circle which passes through the apogee as well as the perigee. Now this circle will have its radius which will be equal to the semi-major axis of this ellipse, because if this is the ellipse, this will be the same, this will be the major axis, and this length will be the semi-major axis. Now this satellite will move along this ellipse with an angular velocity which will keep on varying with time. The velocity at this point will be the highest as the distance is the least, and the velocity at this point will be the lowest as this distance is the maximum possible distance between the satellite and the Earth in this orbit. So this satellite will have an angular velocity, that is d theta. If this is d theta, then the d theta by dt will keep on changing over time. And now let's imagine another satellite which will be traveling on this path, on this circular path, and the center body. The central body is the body along which the satellite will orbit. If the central body is located somewhere over here, and the satellite, instead of going along this orbital path, it follows this circular path. Instead of going on this elliptical path, the satellite goes on this circular path, and let's say the Earth for this satellite will be over here. So here we have our Earth, and here we have our hypothetical satellite which is moving along this hypothetical orbit. And this is the Earth we made earlier. Let's say this is a real Earth and the real satellite. So this satellite which will be moving along this circular path will have a constant angular velocity. The d theta by dt for this satellite, for the satellite traveling in this orbit, will be constant. Let's call it alpha to avoid any confusion. D alpha. So d alpha by dt this will always be constant. Now let's say that the angular velocity of the satellite moving in this orbit is equal to 2 pi by t, where t is the time period of the satellite traveling in the elliptical orbit. By time period I mean something like, say the satellite starts at this point and it goes along this orbit, goes, and then from this point it starts returning back to the perigee. The time taken to complete one revolution along this orbit will be the time period of this satellite. So let's consider a hypothetical satellite which is moving along this circular path with an angular velocity 2 pi by t. Now let's say both these satellites, the red one and the blue one, they start at a time t naught from this point. So here we have our satellites at time t naught, both the satellites are over here only. Now at time t naught plus delta t, the red satellite comes somewhere over here and the blue satellite it comes at this point. So at t naught plus delta t, the true anomaly for this satellite will be this angle theta, and at time t naught plus delta t, the mean anomaly for this satellite will be this angle m. Anomaly for this satellite at time t naught plus delta t is this theta, the angle between the position vector and the perigee. Position vector for this satellite is this line and the eccentricity vector is this. So the true anomaly for this satellite at t naught plus delta t is this angle theta, and the true and the mean anomaly for this satellite will be the position vector, will be the angle subtended by the position vector of the hypothetical satellite moving along this circular path, and it will be the angle between this position vector and the same line which coincides with the eccentricity vector, the line joining the center of this hypothetical Earth and the perigee. So at time t naught plus delta t, this will be the mean anomaly for this satellite. At time t naught plus say 2 delta t, this satellite it comes somewhere over here. So let's draw this with a red pen, and this satellite it comes somewhere over here. Now the true anomaly for this satellite will be this angle. This is the position vector and this angle. We'll call this angle theta 2. So this is theta 2. True anomaly for this satellite at time t naught plus 2 delta t, and the mean anomaly for this satellite at t naught plus 2 delta t will be this angle. So I hope I have been able to explain you the concept of mean anomaly. If you you guys have any question, just mail us and we'll try to get back to you. And thank you for watching the video.